Hi, my friends. I have been accumulating makeup since it all started to release and drop. This is my favorite time of year. Drugstore makeup comes out with some absolutely amazing things, and it's when all the affordable goodies hit, is around the beginning of the year. So I have a bunch that we're gonna get into right now. And yeah, we're gonna talk kind of fast and go through it kind of quickly because I have so much to share with you. Let's do this review right now. All right, what's new at the drugstore is a whole lot. We're gonna get into it immediately. This is from Essence. These are two sprays, which I really actually do like a lot. Both of these are from Essence. They are oil-free and they are alcohol-free, which I think is great for a drugstore company to be able to come out with this. This one is called Hello Good Stuff. It's Hydrate and Fix and Refresh with watermelon extract. And yes, it does smell like watermelon. I'm not crazy about having fragrance in my skincare, but this is actually watermelon extract that makes it smell. It might have a little bit of fragrance in there as well, but this doesn't irritate my skin at all. And the same thing with the Fix and Last 18-hour makeup fixing spray. This is for the matte effect and it's waterproof. Now, I don't find that it makes my skin too matte. I use it to set my under eye concealer. I've actually used both of these, actually used this one on this side today and this one on this side, and I don't think you can tell much difference as far as the finish goes. So it kind of depends on whether or not you want that watermelon in there, and there is hyaluronic acid in this one. So this one's going to keep you a little bit more matte. I assume this one's going to be a little bit better in the summertime. We shall see. So here are both of those so that you can see those as well. But right now I'm enjoying both of those and I wanted to tell you about them. I have two primers, which I really do like, but by far the Milani is my favorite. The LA Girl Luminous Glow. This is the Skin Illuminator. You actually don't have to use this one just as a primer. You could use that as an actual highlight. It does leave a little bit more of a white cast than I would like as a highlight. So that's why I go in with it first and then my foundation. But personally, I'm not as impressed with that one as I am with this one. And this is the Milani Skin Quench Hydrating Primer with Hyaluronic Acid, Coconut Water. So heads up, if you're allergic to coconut, you want to be careful about that one. So here is the product so that you can see that. And this I have on today. I've been wearing it since I got it. I love this. If you are a fan of the City Beauty Veil Primer, I like that one too. It's really good. It has skin-loving ingredients in it. I think this one is better. It grips my makeup a little bit better. I love it because I can tell by the consistency of it that it does have a little bit of that pore refining effect in it. So it might have a little bit of dimethicone in it, but I can feel that grip. And I know that this is not a brand new product. This is basically repackaged, possibly reformulated product, but I had never tried this particular one before and I love it. I absolutely love it. It is so nice on the skin as you're rubbing it in and it doesn't feel heavy or greasy. It feels hydrating. So if you have oily skin, you might want to skip it, but I know that Milani just released all of theirs in this repackaged formula. So maybe take a look at some of those that leave you a little bit more matte if you are oily. A couple that I want to tell you steer clear of. I went to my Walgreens and I got these from Rimmel, and these are the Mini Power Palette Eye, Lip, and Cheek Palettes. Okay, it has a cream product right here. You can tell that this hardly looks like I've done anything to it. I don't like this formula at all. This is so patchy and so nasty on both of these, and it has that cream product in there that doesn't do a darn thing. I'm sorry, but it just doesn't. And both of these that I got were they just fell so short for me. So I'm not impressed with those at all. I didn't feel like I could get enough of a pigment out of them in order to do a really nice look. I am going to swatch for you though these fun little mini palettes that just came out from e.l.f. It's the bite-sized ones again, and I'll throw the names up on the screen for you and I will show you the two side by side. Please know that even though yes, I am shaking, I have a palsy that is a disability and I just try not to let it run my life. I try to run it, but sometimes it gets the better of me, and today I'm a little bit more shaky than usual. Let me show you the swatches. This is this one on the top right here, and I really like the pigment on these. It's the same quality as their other quad shadows. And then this one right here, beautiful yummy mint cool toned palette. so pretty. I really have been impressed with these and really have been liking working with them. And actually today I am wearing both of these in kind of a combination on my eyes today, so that you do know that. And then ColourPop released these 5 pan palettes that I'm assuming that they're trying to dupe Natasha Denona. And I will throw up on the screen what these are called. They're very nice quality. Again, they're pretty much the same as all of the other of ColourPop shadows. I've enjoyed working with them. They're a good formula. They stay on, they blend, all of the good things that you need. I will say that a couple of them kind of get a little bit repetitive, and I'll show you what I mean by that. So if you look at these three that I have right here, look at this color right here. I know it's looking a little bit different on camera, but pretty much that is the same color across the board. And then these colors that are down here, you kind of have the same thing. You have that high metallic, almost, you know, white cast. So I feel like they could have done just a tiny bit better job of these. The other thing that I'm not crazy about is that middle pan really chunky glitter. Both of these have that super chunky glitter in them. So again, the quality on these is every bit as good as ColourPop has. You know that I'm a ColourPop fan, so I do like these. My worry with ColourPop is that they bring so much out that they don't really take time to restock it and get us to love some of their products. They are just like the one hit per week wonder, and they just want us to buy and buy over and over again different things. All right, from Catrice, this is their camouflage cream, and this one is called Wake Up Effect, and this is a color corrector for light skin gals. They do have a couple other colors of these that are a little bit more along the lines of yellow, so if you're a deeper skin gal, you might really like those as color correctors. This is a great color corrector if you are super fair skinned. I just wanted to mention it. It's got a nice consistency about it. Although, you know, I wish that they would be inclusive of colors. This one really is a lot like the Pixie little brightener in Brightening Peach, I think it is. And then they have another one that is, I can't remember what the other one's called. Catrice came out with a lot of new products. Some were hits, some were misses. I did like that color corrector. They also came out with this True Skin Hydrating Foundation, Hyaluronic Acid Longwear Foundation, has a pump. It's a really nice delivery system with a glass bottle. It is what I'm wearing today. I have kind of fallen in love with this. It does look very natural, and it's just a beautiful foundation on my skin. Wears really well throughout the day, and yeah, I'm really, really liking it. And the way it covers and everything that it's done for my skin. And then they have the eye foundation that is not good. I don't like this one at all. And the reason is because for my eye primer, I really like getting ones that kind of take out the darkness that I have. This is just a clear one. There's no color in it at all. But if you are one that doesn't need that opaque color on your lids in order to take out darkness, you might really like this because it did keep the shadow on. I didn't care for it as much as I do my Anastasia Beverly Hills, which I talk about in every tutorial. I also tried their Powerful 5 lip gloss. This is a nice lip gloss. I do like it. This one is called Liche Glaze. It's a pretty color. I do really like it. Okay, so it says it has hyaluronic acid, vitamin E, shea butter, green tea, and goji berries. So it's got a lot of really good ingredients in it. It's very nourishing feeling. It doesn't have any sort of a plumping effect to it. It's not sticky at all. It really hydrates my lips and really gives that full pout that I like about any sort of a lip gloss. And it definitely has all those skin-loving ingredients in it. And along with that, I also got the Diamond Plumper from Physicians Formula. I thought this was one that I would really like. I'm not crazy about the formula at all. Actually, Physicians Formula just came out with a bunch of stuff. I had some of it in my video that was disappointing at the drugstore. It's just a clear gloss. It isn't anything to write home about. It has that kind of medicine-y smell to it, vitamin-y smell, I shouldn't say medicine-y smell to it. So I'm not really impressed with it, but I do really like the Catrice one. And then e.l.f. has their shadow sticks, and they kind of expanded their line of colors, and I am in love with these. Now this one is kind of a brightening pink color, and you're not gonna be able to see it very well. And then this one is a beige color. This is was again in their little mint collection that they just released. That is kind of just a beautiful, it's a high metallic, almost a champagne color to it. And then this one is the blue that is like a cornflower blue, which You don't see that very much in shadows. And I love these. I love working with these on days when I just wanna just get out the door. So I'll just put it across my eyelids or in the crease, and then I'll just really lightly buff it with my fingers. And they're very easy to work with, and they blend out really nice and smoothly. So if you need a like one and done, these are really nice. And they last a long time after they set down, and I love that about them. Essence also came out with new lip liners. I am so bummed out at this. On the Essence website, you can still get my favorite, the contouring a lip pencil, which was basically what these are. Same thing, they've just brought out different colors, tried to reformulate it or tried to say it's new, whatever they're trying to do. I'm just not very happy with this because of the colors. This one is a kind of a nude peach. The next one is kind of supposed to be a rose, but again, it pulls a little orange. And then the next one, and they all look the same. Look at those. They look exactly the same. I got three colors thinking, okay, well, these are all gonna be different. Mauve, rose, that kind of thing. They're all the same. So I'm disappointed in those big time. Another disappointment, please save your money, is from L'Oreal, the Infallible 24-Hour Fresh Wear Foundation, Powder Foundation. I am not impressed with this at all. If you are an older woman, and I don't know why they even bothered with this, honestly. Has a little puff underneath with the mirror. L'Oreal's packaging is very nice. I love that about them. But the product is just so, so chalky. And that is not something that I can do on my mature skin. It might be for somebody else, but it does not wear or look anything like a regular powder foundation does or a mineral foundation does. It just looks really, really cakey and yuck. I found another two products from Catrice. This is the Triangle Artist Contour Stick from them. And this one I do like, but not for a contour. So they've used that triangle effect. I don't remember which company it is that actually has. I think it's their foundations. Somebody has this where they think you can just, you know, draw it on there and it be the best contour. Well, I'll tell you what, this is way too warm for a contour, for me anyway. If you've ever seen any of my videos where I talk about contour and you know how to do that on your face, I don't like an orange contour or a warm contour as opposed to a cool contour that is going to look like a shadow. This looks like warmth. I do like this as a cream bronzer, and I'll just put my stipple brush around in there, and then I will just, you know, do a little bit of warmth up against my skin. I'm loving cream products. The product in here itself is nice. It's a creamy product. I would not, if I were you, do what I just did and draw it on your skin and then try to buff it out. It just doesn't work as well as just putting it onto a brush and then stippling it onto your skin. It's easy to blend out. It's not bad at all. I just think you would get too much down if you tried to just draw it on in the beginning of whatever you're doing. So I do like this. I just don't like it as a contour, but I really do like it as a bronzer. It's a really beautiful cream bronzer. Also from Catrice is the More Than a Glow Highlighter. This is one that is so pretty. I love that Catrice does their little imprint on there. You can tell I've already been using this a ton because the imprint's almost gone of those little flowers. But this is a beautiful highlighter that I do have on underneath my blush today. It is gorgeous, and it is just the most beautiful glow. No sparkle, no glitter. It just gives you that very high metallic look. If you go in that strong as I did right there, you can buff it out. So if you're somebody that just likes a little bit of glow, you can buff it out for sure. You know, use again that stipple brush. I always find it works so well, or a nice fan brush that works really well to put on a little bit. But putting it underneath your blush, every time it will work so good. So Wet n Wild recently released a bunch of stuff as well. You all know if you watched my video on disappointing products that I am not a fan of their new shadow formula. I don't know what they were thinking, but it just doesn't work for me. It's not one that I like. But they did also come out with the Incognito Full Coverage Concealer. Actually really like this. Normally when a concealer comes out from Wet n Wild, I'm not that crazy about it, but I am wearing it today. I felt like it did a great job of concealing all of my imperfections along with the Catrice corrector. They just worked really well together. If you take it and use the very, very smallest amount that you possibly can, it's going to work a lot better for you than if you go in with a heavy hand. So I actually use, again, I've gotten into using brushes so much. You can do it on your beauty blender if you like to too. Just a tiny bit on the brush and then stipple just a little bit. Let it set down a little bit, go back in, and it's just been working so nicely for me. Basic doe foot applicator, and you can tell right there, hopefully you can tell, that it is a pretty good coverage on it. So I've been really enjoying this. Also, e.l.f. came out with a new mascara, Lash In Loud Mascara. I like this a lot. It is a plastic applicator or a brush instead of the actual natural bristle brush that they have on so many. I think that's why I like it, because I don't have a ton of lashes. They're long, but I don't have a ton. So I actually like that the plastic bristles can kind of define those a little bit more. This is great to build on. It is what I have on today, and I've really been enjoying it. I did a video where I showed you the Essence one that I absolutely fall in love with, and I still like that one a little bit better for its staying power. But as far as what it does for the lashes, this is a pretty darn close second to it. And I also did try, because so many of you were asking me to try, the Sky High from Maybelline mascara. This is pretty nice, and I do like it. The wand, again, is a plastic wand, but I will tell you what I don't like about the wand. Look at how it bends. The wand can completely bend. I don't like that, because I feel like when I go down into my eye, the wand is bending with my eye instead of getting that base of the lashes that I can wiggle and then up, because it's bending. And so I'm not crazy about that delivery system. The product itself is pretty good. I do like it. I love all of Maybelline's mascaras, honestly. I think Maybelline is a brand at the drugstore that just knows how to do mascaras. I actually really like this packaging too. It's got some embossing on it. I did try to use it to build up like crazy, and then I ended up going in with the e.l.f. on this eye to get my last final bit of length out of my eyelashes that I wanted to. So it's pretty good. I can give it a thumbs up. Probably, if I was gonna say 4 out of 5 stars, the e.l.f. and the Essence ones that I've shown you before, those are like 4.5 out of 5 stars. So definitely like that one, but this one goes down a notch just because of that bendy little bit of a wand, and that kind of drives me a little bit crazy. And then e.l.f. also came out with this dual-ended brush for foundation and for concealer. I love this. It's great. It reminds me of the IT Cosmetics foundation brush that they have, the duo one. It's actually almost identical to it. So if you're wondering about that, it is a great brush. I'm a big fan of e.l.f. brushes anyway. These are soft. They're really nice. They buff in your foundation really well. If you're going to use powder foundation, this would probably be a really good one if you needed a lot of coverage, but it's great for liquid foundation. And I've just been really liking both sides of it. I love these little concealer brushes that I've been using lately, and they work so well. All right, that is it, I think, for what's new at the drugstore. I hope you guys did enjoy this little bit of a review. All of these products I've been trying for a while. Nothing in here is anything that I just tried once or haven't tried at all. So I like bringing you full reviews before I dive in and say yay or nay, so you kind of get a good idea of what I'm liking and what just does not work. Thank you guys so much for spending a little bit of your day with me today. Have you picked up any of these products yet? And are there any that I have not seen yet that are in here? I do have a few high-end items that I'm going to review for you in probably my monthly favorites this month of things that I am kind of quite liking. So watch for that. Thanks so much for spending a bit of your day with me. Hope everybody is happy, healthy, stay safe. I love you very much, and I'll talk to you in my next video. Bye, friends.